magical friends. I'm Ellie Eberts, your local Mew Mew obsessed cosplayer, back with another build vlog. This time for the lone wolf of the team, Mew Zakuro. Mew Zakuro is the fifth Mew Mew and the final to join the team in the anime. She is the oldest of the Mews and the most mature. Mixed with the DNA of a gray wolf, her outfit features a strapless crop top with purple fur trim, purple shorts, a pair of thigh-high boots, wrist cuffs, and of course, her Mew Mew accessories. I think my favorite part of this outfit is the fur trim on the bodice. Mew Ichigo's bodice has a similar fur trim, and I just think it is so cute. In today's video, I'm going to show you my process for the shorts, bodice, boots, tail, and ears. This video has been split into chapters, so if you're interested in a specific part, feel free to skip ahead to that section. All right, let's get started. Let's start by making the shorts. For Zakuro's costume, I chose this beautiful plum stretch velvet. I'm using my favorite pant pattern. It's one that I've had for forever. And since I didn't make a mock-up, I cut my pattern with a few extra inches on the sides and waist. I also split both pieces down the center to add the detail stitching that can be seen on Zakuro's shorts. I cut pieces for my lining from the same plum velvet. With my pieces cut, I began assembling the legs. I stitched all seams besides the inner leg. After stitching the pieces together, I pressed the seams open and top stitched on both sides of the seams. Once the top stitch was completed, I stitched up the inner leg and then stitched together the crotch seam. Then I top stitched around the crotch seam. After stitching together the lining, I placed the lining inside the fashion layer. Normally, I would stitch together my fashion and lining layers by machine, but since I've already stitched together the crotch seam, it would be impossible. So I stitched the two layers together by hand. Costume last April, I asked my Twitter where they thought the waistband should be, the high waist or the low waist. They unanimously said the high waist, but as I was preparing for this video, I realized that I preferred the look of the low waist, so I ended up moving the waistband. The waistband is made from a 5-inch wide strip of my velvet. I wanted the seams of the shorts to carry through the waistband, so I made pin tucks on the waistband that matched with the shorts. I stitched the waistband to the shorts. And then, to keep the waistband flat and even, I inserted 1-inch elastic. The shorts can just slip on and they're super comfortable. Also, I love how comfy the velvet lining is. Next, we're going to work on the bodice. I made my bodice of the same stretch velvet as the shorts. I was able to use my trusty Mew Ichigo pattern for the bodice and simply shortened it to stop right below the bust. I cut 2 copies of this pattern from my velvet and 1 from my duck canvas. As usual, I will be using the duck canvas as a structure layer to hold my steel bones. I started by creating boning channels out of strips of duck canvas. I stitched these to the canvas layers and inserted the bones. Once each piece had its bones, I basted my fashion layer onto the canvas layer. So now the layers act as one. Next, I stitch my pieces together. Just like with the shorts, I added top stitching next to every seam. Once my bodice was assembled, I added the fur trim. The fur I'm using has a slight amount of stretch to the grain, so I don't need to worry about cutting it on the bias so it'll stretch over the curve of the bust. I simply cut a strip of fur that was as long as the bust line of my bodice and about 3 inches wide. I stitched this piece to the top of my bodice, and then I added my lining layer. I placed the lining on my fashion layer with right sides touching, and the fur pressed upwards towards the seam. Then I stitched the two pieces together from one side to the other. The fur got caught between the two layers, so when we flip the lining to the inside, some of the fur is poking out. Now, this fur is way too long for this look. So after brushing the fur out of the seam, I trimmed it with my scissors until it was a length that I liked. Next, I'm going to add the band to the hem of the bodice. Just like with the shorts, I cut a length of velvet that was about 5 inches wide, then I added pin tucks to match with the seams in the bodice. Then I basted the velvet piece onto a canvas piece of approximately the same size. Once they were together, I stitched the band onto the bottom of my bodice. Then I turned it over and line stitched it to the lining. My bodice closes in the back with hook and bars. While I could have used a separating zipper, I figured that this closure is so short that hook and bars do just as well. Just like the shorts, this bodice is super warm and cozy due to the velvet lining. I also think that it's really, really flattering. I really like it so far. Now that the main outfit is completed, we can move on to the accessories, like Zakuro's super cool thigh-high boots. Ooh, I think these are so cool and I am super excited to make them. I wanted my boots to match the rest of my outfit, so I again used my stretch velvet. I started by wrapping my leg in plastic wrap and tape. This is essentially making a copy of my leg that I can then take my pattern from. Once my leg was wrapped, I drew on my pattern. For these boots, this was simply a front and a back seam. Then I cut the plastic wrap off of my leg. Here's a look at my pattern. It looks kind of silly, but it worked really well. Now I cut 4 copies of my pattern from my velvet. If you're going to follow this method, it's really important that you use a stretch material. I am completely relying on the stretch of my fabric for these boots. Otherwise, honestly, they wouldn't fit at all. Now, I stitched together my leg pieces, leaving only an opening at the bottom for the heel of my shoe and at the top for my leg. Next, I folded over the hem of the leg opening and added elastic to help keep the boots up. Lastly, we will be making a set of ears and a tail for Zakuro. I've made lots of animal ears recently, so I already had a base pattern for Zakuro's ears. I cut 2 copies of my pattern from my purple fur and 2 copies from a white fur. I also cut 2 half moon shapes from my purple fur and an exclamation mark shape as well. These will be for the tail. First, I'm going to stitch together my ear pieces. Right now, they just look like blobs of fur, but after trimming, they will look a lot nicer. Right now, they just look like blobs of fur, but after some trimming, they will look a lot nicer. Using my scissors, I'm trimming the fur on my ears until they begin to look a bit more like wolf ears. I'm going to leave the fur a bit longer at the bottom so it can fade into my wig. I've also seen people use an electric razor to trim fur, so if you have a razor that you don't mind getting like super messy and furry, then you can try using that as well. Now, using watered down acrylic paints and some eyeshadows, I'm going to color my ears. Specifically, I'm adding lots of color along the seam between my 2 types of fur. This makes it look more natural. I'm also adding some color to the inside curve of the ear. I'm cutting 2 copies of my ear pattern from thermoplastic sheeting. I then heated my thermoplastic with a hairdryer and bent it into a curved ear shape. Now I can insert this shape between the 2 layers of my ears. I used hot glue at the tip of the ear and along the inside curve of the ear to help the fur stick to the plastic. Then I glued together the fur at the bottom of the ear. Finally, I sewed my ears onto wig clips. If I were to make these ears now, I would probably put them onto a headband. I find that headbands are a lot easier to use and make it a lot easier when you're getting dressed, so you don't have to worry about putting the ears in exactly the right spot, since the headband has them glued into place and you don't have to worry about like one ear being over here and one up here. So just an FYI that if you have a headband, I would suggest using that for your ears. Now for the tail, I'm going to stitch together my half moon shapes along the bottom curve. Then I'm going to add my exclamation mark shape between the two pieces on the inner curve. This pattern is based on one I found on fursuit websites. It makes a really natural curve to a tail. Now, with my tail turned inside out, I'm going to make a wire armature for it. I'm simply bending my wire into the shape of a dog's tail and leaving enough wire on the ends to make a base. I'm now stuffing my tail with fiberfill and inserting my wire armature. Next, I need to create the base. I'm using some wool felt. I've used this material for all of my tails. It's thick enough to protect your skin from the wires, but also really soft. I folded my felt into a square that is 4 layers thick. Then I cut a slit into the top 2 layers that I slip my wire into. Now I'm going to stitch through all 4 layers of felt over my wire with a zigzag stitch. Catch me wearing my super fashionable safety goggles. It's super easy to break a needle while stitching this, so it's important to protect yourself with goggles. Now that it's been stitched in place, I'm going to trim my base to be a bit more square, and then I'm going to add 2 sets of ribbon that will hold my tail in place. Finally, I'm hand stitching my tail onto the base. All that's left for the tail is a bit of detailing. All that's left is to finish it off with my Mew Mew accessories. Cosplay. I really like the way this costume came out. I feel really, really cool when I'm wearing it. My favorite part has to be the thigh-high boots, followed by our material choice. You know, choosing unique materials that play off the girls' personalities has been one of my favorite parts about making all of these Mew Mew costumes. Even though I finished this costume back in April of last year, I held off on making the video until, well, now. I guess part of me wasn't really happy with the way this costume came out. It's just, it doesn't feel like the most flattering thing on me. But I did make some alterations between then and now, and I like the costume a lot more. So I guess it's important to remember that we can always change, upgrade, or alter our costumes. I mean, there's no rule that says we can only wear a costume once, right? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. It's been so fun to cosplay as Zakuro. She's not really my usual type. So it's been a bit of an experience. I hope you enjoyed joining me for the ride. If you did, be sure to leave a comment and like the video. It really helps me a lot to know that you like what you're watching. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow me on Instagram. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, be sure to keep sewing, stay positive, and have fun. I'll see you later. Bye!